Hi everyone, let us solve one more problem on the model 1 and model 2 type of queuing the system. So this is the second problem I am going to solve. So please see here. So this is a realistic problem if you observe. So the arrivals at a telephone booth are considered to be poison with an average time of 10 minutes between one arrival to the next. The length of phone call is assumed to be distributed exponentially with mean 3 minutes. So now he is asking us the four values. So first one is, what is the probability that a person arriving at the booth will have to wait? Next, the telephone department will install a second booth when convinced that an arrival would expect waiting for at least 3 minutes for a phone call. By how much the flow of arrivals should increase in order to justify a second booth? And next, third bit, he asks, what is the average length of queue that forms time to time? And fourth one is, what is the probability that it will take him more than 10 minutes altogether to wait for the phone call and complete his call? So these are the four things we need to find. So before getting into the solving of problem, first of all, we need to identify under which model this problem will fall. So here in the problem itself, it was given that the arrival at a telephone booth is considered to be poison. So the arrival type is poison. Poison arrival rate is represented by M. Next. And with an average time of 10 minutes. And next, the length of phone call is assumed to be distributed exponentially. So the service, so talking with a phone call is distributed exponentially. So the service is also exponentially. Exponentially is also represented by M. And next, the number of servers. So here only a single telephone booth is there, so that means the number of servers is also 1. And next, how many number of customers are coming? So it was not given mention, so that's why we are taking it is the telephone booth is going to be giving service to infinite number of persons or customers. And next, what is the service discipline? So it was also not mentioned. That means whoever are coming first, they are going to talk a phone call. So that means the service discipline is also of FIFO, first in, first out. So M1 infinity FYFO. So this is model number 1. So now we have to use the formula which already discussed under model number 1. Right? So now for solving any problem, already I told to you, first of all we need to calculate two terms. One is arrival rate and second one is service rate. So now let us discuss. So what is the data given to us? Arrivals at a telephone booth are considered to be poison with an average time of 10 minutes. So that means arrival time was given to us. So arrival time is 10 minutes. Arrival time. So let us write arrival time is equals to 10 minutes. And next, the length of phone call is assumed to be distributed exponentially with a mean of 3 minutes. So that means how much time the customer is going to talk in the telephone booth, that is nothing but service time. So service time was given to us. Service time is equals to 3 minutes. So here arrival time and service time were given to us, but we require arrival rate and service rate. So arrival rate lambda is equals to 1 by arrival time, that equals to 1 by 10 persons per minute, right? And similarly, we need to calculate the service rate. So service rate mu is equals to 1 by service time. So that equals to 1 by, what is service time? 1 by 3. that equals to 1 by 3 persons per minute, right? That is the thing given to us. Now let us solve the 1 by 1 question which was given in the problem. So we found out lambda, that is 1 by 10, and mu, that is 1 by 3. So now let us calculate the first bit. So what is the first bit he asked? Probability that a person has to wait at the booth. So single person only has to wait at the booth. So that's why we are taking it as P of n greater than 0 is equals to, already we have a formula for P of n is equals to P naught. P n greater than equals 0 is 1 minus P naught. If we substitute P naught value, then we will get lambda by mu. So what is lambda? 1 by 10 by what is mu? 1 by 3. So then you will get 3 by 10, right? So what is 3 by 10? That means 0.3. okay, then next let us calculate the second bit. He is asking us, he is going to install a second booth. So in order to justify the second telephone booth, what should be the arrival rate? So in order to justify the installation of the second booth, the arrival rate should be more than the waiting time. So if the waiting time is less, then there is no need to install the second booth. But the if you want to increase the waiting time, then the arrival rate should be more. So what is the new arrival rate in order to justify the installation of the second booth? So I am taking the new arrival rate as lambda dash. So lambda dash be the increased arrival rate. Then what is the expected waiting time in the queue will be a WQ. I am going to calculate. So generally we know that WQ formula, lambda by mu into mu minus lambda. But now I am taking the new arrival rate as lambda dash. So in place of lambda, I am writing lambda dash. Then the formula will be WQ is equals to lambda dash by mu into mu minus lambda dash. So now let us calculate the lambda dash. So already we know that the waiting time in the queue is nothing but 3 minutes is equals to lambda dash we need to find by mu. What is the mu value? So how much we got? Mu is equals to 1 by 3. So here already we have calculated mu is equals to 1 by 3 is equals to mu is 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 minus lambda dash. So why I have written here WQ as 3? In the problem itself it was mentioned the expected waiting for at least 3 minutes for a phone call. So the waiting time is 3 minutes he has already given. So that's why WQ I have taken as 3. So 3 is equals to lambda dash by 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 minus lambda dash. If you solve it, you will get lambda dash is equals to 1 by lambda dash is equals to, we will get as 6 minutes. So then what about the lambda dash? 1 by 6 person per minute. So this is the new arrival rate. So what is the old arrival rate? Old arrival rate is 1 by 10. And what is the new arrival rate? New arrival rate is 1 by 6. So then what is the change in arrival rate? So let us calculate that one. So the change in or increase in arrival rate is equals to, so new arrival rate is 1 by 6 and the old arrival rate is 1 by 10. So now what is the difference? 1 by 6 minus 1 by 10, if you take 60, next 10 minus 6 you will get, so 4 by 60, that is 1 by 15. And that equals to 1 by 15 means 0.06 persons per minute. So this one is the increase in arrival rate. Okay, so that if arrival rate is increasing means the waiting time is going to increase to 3 minutes, and so that the installation of the second booth can be justified. And next, the third bit he has asked us, average length of a busy period. Already we have a formula, length means L, busy period B, so LB. So for LB formula we have that equals to mu by mu minus lambda. So now substitute, what is the mu value? Already we have found out 1 by 3 by mu, 1 by 3 minus lambda is 1 by 10. So that equals to 1 by 3 by, here the LCM is 30, 10 minus 3 here you will get. So 1 by 3 by 10 minus 3 is 7 by 30. So 3 ones, 3 tens. Then you will get 10 by 7. So what is 10 by 7? 1.43 minutes. So that is the average length of busy period. Okay. Next, so the telephone booth is going to be busy for a period of 1.43 minutes, right? Next, what is the fourth bit he has asked? Probability of waiting for 10 minutes or more is given. So we have to find out that one, probability of waiting. So waiting minutes he has given is 10 minutes. So generally the waiting time is only 3 minutes. So now he is asking us if, what is the probability of waiting more than 10 minutes? So already we have the formula P of W greater than or equals to WQ. So that is, the formula is integral T to infinity lambda by mu into mu minus lambda into e power minus of mu minus lambda into T into dt. So now let us substitute all values. Integral T value is given 10 minutes. So 10 to infinity, and already we know that lambda is 1 by 10 by mu is 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 minus 1 by 10 into e power minus of 1 by 3 minus 1 by 10, t value is 10 into dt, sorry, t into dt, right? So that equals to, if you solve this, what you will get? Integral 10 to infinity. Here you will get 0.3, and this relation you will get 0.23 e power, the same relation we have, right? Minus of 0.23 into t dt. So that equals to 0.3 into 0.23. So that equals to 0.069. Integral of e power minus t means e power minus t, that is 0.-23t by minus x. So the coefficient we are going to write in the denominator. So that is minus 0.23 within the limits of 10 to infinity. Now substitute the limits, then you will get the answer as 0.03. So that means there is a chance of 0.03 means only 3%. So there is a chance of only 3% that the customer is going to wait more than 10 minutes. Okay. So in 100% time, only 3% chance is only there the customer is going to be wait more than 10 minutes. So like this, we are going to solve the realistic problems using the queuing model relationships. Okay. So I hope you understand this problem. If you understand, please like this video and subscribe to the channel, share the video. Thank you.